I was born in 1932. I knew my father's name, but I didn't want to get his name because I thought it was not respectful. It was Mr. Pereira, George Pereira. A lot of awkward people went and bought those names. He still remembers me as a good teacher. He sent me even to Timbuktu. Any place is all right. I can't buy them. Because the bad books are politicians.
A.C.S. Swami, yes. But he's also your neighbor.
And my relative.
Also related to Dr. Mao.
Yes, that if you, my doors are wide open for you to go.
Welcome to the program. Today we are speaking to Mr. Ghafoor. Ghafoor principal made a lot of contributions to education in Akurana, as far as I have heard. In 2013, when I went to Sri Lanka, we had a long conversation with him. I took brother Irfan with me. Unfortunately, we did not record any of that. It was a very rich, healthy conversation for over 2 hours. All sorts of things about education in the past as well as in the present. This time when I went to Sri Lanka again, I took brother Irfan to meet him and then we had a conversation and some of it we recorded and happy to share with you. Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Mr. Ghafoor, tell me about yourself. When were you born?
About my life. I was born in 1932. Right. I was born in Akurana.
Then tell me about your early years.
Early years? We shifted to Kolkata. My parents shifted to Kolkata because my father has lands here in Kolkata.
Yeah.
He didn't have much land. He had only half an acre. My mother had only half an acre. In that place. That was a place where you could not cultivate anything very much because the soil was such.
Right.
So he wanted to come and settle down in Kolkata. He built a house.
Right.
He came here somewhere in 1939, I think. 38 or 39, no diaries were kept.
Around that period.
So, while in Akurana, my mother, she was the daughter of the Khatib of the Akurana Grand Mosque.
Right. Palayapalli.
Palayapalli, yes. That family had a tradition of teaching people. She taught Quran
right.
to the children in that area.
Your mother?
My mother. They were mats. Mm-hmm. So we sat on the mats. I also joined them.
Right.
And some of us completed the Quran, the Muppa Juzu.
Yeah.
Under her.
Yeah.
All. For no payment.
Yeah.
No payment. Even for teaching them Quran or what they call Tholugadavu.
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 Yeah.
Or that even my father also helped once in a way. All this without any payment.
Right.
Yes. Then I was also the eye part of the classes. I did very well in Quran reading.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then from there, we came to Kolkata in 38 or 39.
Right.
So I was sent to this Akurana Tamil school. It was known as Tamil school at that time. Yeah. Present was Azhar.
Yeah.
Was known as Akurana Tamil school.
Right.
The headmaster and the other members of the staff were all people from Jaffna.
Right.
When I went to the class, that is Arivari at that time it was
Arivari,
called.
Yes.
Arivari.
Yes.
I was asked my father's name.
Yeah.
I knew my father's name, but I didn't want to get his name because I thought it was not respectful for him. It was not respectful for me to call my father by his name.
Right.
I did not tell his name.
Okay.
So I refused. So, principal. Then he said, I won't register you in the school register. I said, all right. I kept quiet.
Right.
So after a long time, I was registered as a student there. And my admission number was 1607.
That is fantastic. You have an excellent memory. So you are 87 year old now.
Yes. Mm. Then from this Arivari, I got a double promotion.
Right.
I got a double promotion, I think. Double promotion to grade 2.
Mm.
Arivari, then...
Grade 2.
The classes were Arivari.
Mm.
Then the upper division of Arivari. That was another class. First class was Arivari lower division.
Mm-hmm.
Second was Arivari upper division.
Mm-hmm.
Third was grade 2.
Okay.
So I was able to jump the Arivari upper division.
Mm-hmm.
So they thought I was good enough to go to the grade 2
mm-hmm.
without sitting in grade 1.
Okay.
They gave me a double promotion.
Mm-hmm.
From there, I, like any other schoolboy, was there, we were there playing and so on and so forth. And there was a one day man, mm-hmm. old man.
Mm-hmm.
I still remember. He was selling one day,
mm-hmm.
1 cent a one day.
Mm-hmm.
Big, nice one day, well baked.
One vade cost 1 cent.
Yes, one vade cost 1 cent. Those days, as pocket money to go to school, we were given 2 cents or 3 cents at most.
Right.
If I get 5 cents, you are a rich man.
Right.
You are a rich man.
Right.
So he used to say, Masipan vade and all that, and we used to go and buy it for the interval. We used to go to the boutiques in the by the roadside. This man had all the business. So, if you buy a vade for 3 cents, that big vade, you share it with your friends. If you are rich enough, you buy one for 3 cents.
Do you remember some other contemporaries who studied with you?
Studied with me? Who? What the?
Other people, classmates.
Not classmates, schoolmates. Yeah. I remember some of them. One is Mr. Zubair. He was the chairman of the Ceylon Electricity Board some time back.
Yes.
Before that, he specialized in electrical engineering in the university. So we were both supposed to be good students.
Mm-hmm.
He and my father were waiting on the road till the school was over to do it that. Two sons, each take
them. Right.
Zubair was taken by his father, my father took me.
Okay.
Yes. So, at that time, there was a man called Hussein. He knew English.
Right.
People called him Pache Hussein. He was a good speaker. He got onto the stage and he speak very well.
Right.
He was a good speaker. And he taught English there. There was a office like thing where my cousin of mine, a proctor, he rented out that place and he used to come once a week or twice a week for his professional work. This crusade was the clerk.
Right.
Hussein was the clerk. So he taught us English.
Right.
Not in the school, but a private.
Yeah.
He taught us English. So I was one of the very few. My husband Zubair, I think, the other one, was, we did very well in English.
Mm-hmm.
We were able to speak and all that in English at that time. There was nobody to whom you speak to in English because nobody knew English.
Mm.
So, and we were good, all that. And I used to get very good marks. Mr. T.M.S. Hamid. Dr. Maru's father.
Yeah.
He also taught us in 1947. This became a junior school. where English was the medium. The school became a junior school where English was the medium of instruction. People from the grade 6 upwards were taken in there. Grade 6 upwards were taken in there, so I was one of those who were taken in. The principal was one Mr. Pereira, George Pereira. He used to travel from Monterey, very devoted teacher. Principal was a very devoted man. He wanted to do something for the school. He started to build a school, put up a building for the school and all that. And he used to stay here in the school premises at night. And I heard that he used to sleep on benches. Mm-hmm. And next morning go to school from there. So he did so much service. Before he could start and complete the building, he was transferred to some other place.
Right.
Somewhere in 1948 or so, he was transferred to some place down south.
Mm-hmm.
Then one Mr. Mansoor came, Vayala Mansoor. He was from Habastara in Navalapitiya.
Mm.
He came, he was a bit of a revolutionary type of man.
Right.
He never respected traditions and all that. He had his way of doing things. Anyway, he did something for the school. He taught us. Mm-hmm. He was also a good teacher. Not the same type of devotion that George Pereira had. George Pereira went all out to build the school. This Mansoor was a man who revolutionized the internal administration of the school. He did things in a different way. Even department, they looked at him like that, I think, even department of education. There was an English medium school in Akron. That was the English medium school in Akron. People who could not afford to send their children to English medium schools in Kadavas, Kandy. They were very happy
mm-hmm.
that there was an English medium school. I was also one of those. My father was not able to send me to Kadavas or Kandy, but I did very well in the school.
Mm-hmm.
So much so that when Mansoor entered the university, he had been telling the other Muslims, my student will come and defeat all of you.
Mm-hmm.
I was also in the university in this class in Gandhi at that time.
Right.
Yes. So, then Mansoor went and someone else came. Then after some time, on a policy decision, government said all these junior schools will become senior schools and media would be Tamil. So, still there was a demand for English.
Right.
In 49, I had a tiff. I fell out with Mansoor.
Uh-huh.
He was the principal.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't go to this school. So, my cousin who was a lawyer, my father's elder brother's son, they were staying in Kandy.
Mm-hmm.
He never spoke to the people concerned. I'm wearing mid-1949, April or May.
Right.
And got me admitted there. Sylvester's also, I did very well.
Mm-hmm.
I did very well. From there I entered the university.
Right.
After that is my personal life, I have to tell you my godfather. Akuruna,
mm-hmm.
people were not conscious about education at that time. Nobody was bothered about education. Because in such a big population, Akuruna at that time also had a very big Muslim population. Students in the grade 6 and 7 and so on, they numbered up within 15, 20. That's all.
Right.
And there were no grade 6 classes in the other surrounding schools, only Azhar had. And That was, people were not conscious about anything. They were conscious about making money. Economically, they were doing well.
Yes,
buying lands around the village. Because all they all developed good big lands were owned by European, by Englishmen. So they were also living, they were selling these lands. A lot of upper people went and bought those lands. They became rich.
Remember some examples of people who bought big lands in other places? Yes. Some families? Yeah.
Yes. My father-in-law was one. He bought lands. He bought lands in Galagadar, I think. He used to tell us. When we used to travel to Colombo sometimes in his car together. So these things are related. Then Saba, he did not like. He liked tea. He wanted tea estates, about 20 odd acres first, in Arathkoda. Then another 20 odd acres next to Podgalapala. Like that, they were all parts of big, big estates. Like that, he bought lands, my father-in-law was one. Along with that, there were a lot of other, the former headman of Kuruna Mishayas Bowman, very tough man, and people used to sort of respect him and fear him. Then late Mr. Bija, Pagarama also, some people bought lands which were close to, adjacent to Pagarama. Like that, a lot of Kuruna people bought lands. There was a estate called Saistan Estate, surrounding Arathkoda. People bought pieces of that. Then there was also Ankumara Estate. That's a big estate. Mr. Mijan bought the entire thing. He was doing a business in Bartley. He bought that entire big estate those days. An acre went for about, I think, 300 to 400 rupees or 500 rupees most. This land, which my father bought from somebody else, he had paid, I saw the deed, I went through the deed. He had paid 300 rupees for this land. Then a lot of others from Bulhutan also bought lands.
Yes.
I.S. Dean, Chain Lardy. Then the former Qadi at Akurana. I.S. Mohammed, something like that. He was Qadi, he bought lands. People who went out to Colombo, Pinkopoli and various other places like that, they made their money and came and bought lands here, and they devoted their time here on the lands. Because they were giving a good income.
Yeah.
Good income. Labor was cheap. They were very obedient, unlike that now. And all Indian, South Indian labor. And there were not many labor laws. Which used to now guide the relationship between the proprietor and the laborers. So they did, all of them did well. In Saistan, there was a land called Craig and Gilt Estate that was also behind Arathkoda. They all touched on Akurana. Called Benbula Estate, that's near Ukola. That's also one portion. Benbula, that was in that area. There was another estate, Big Hill. That was some name I can't remember. That touched Pagalamada. Surrounding the Akurana area, a lot of big lands were there, big estate. Our people all bought them. It was divided and sold, our people bought that. So that big hilly land I told you behind Pagalamada, my father-in-law bought that.
Right.
It was a jungle at the time he bought. I think he would have bought about 300 acres for within 2,000-3,000 rupees.
Right.
And he developed it. our leading people, some were business in various places, some devoted their time to lunch.
Tell me about bit more about your father.
Yes. My father was the son of a... he belonged to a big Alim family. His father's family was all Alims. Alims. My father's brothers, they were all Alims. They went to this Kitab Madrasa in various places in Gaul and so on. My father went to Gaul. He came out as an Alim. But he didn't get a job as an Alim. He had to come and do some business. His brother took him on, his immediate elder brother. He was also an Alim. So he took father on and they were carrying on a business. Later, father left us there and he did his own business. He was buying trees and making them into usable timber. He was a timber merchant. Like he went on. Then the chief priest, Khatib of Akron, old mosque, was a grandfather or somebody of my mother. Mm-hmm. Wapa's big job was his forefather, his father, brother. They were the chief priests, Khatibs in the Kurukuta mosque. Father followed suit, he was also there, the Khatib. Like that, and he was becoming old, and he devoted all his time to the education of his children. Myself, my younger brother Mohammed, he was on the staff at Kurukuta. Then my younger brother Nalin Din, he is in general law. That he devoted all his time to that. We need to buy all our books, mm-hmm. or get them, buy them by post from Jaffna. And it went on like that. Then after that, he was Khatib at Kurukuta Mosque. Nothing much of a businessman. Mm-hmm. He was nothing much of a businessman. He did his job as a Khatib and his main concern was education of the children. Mm-hmm. I think he succeeded in that.
Yes.
Education of his children, he succeeded. Father also used to cultivate his land. A lot of leisure time, no?
Yeah.
No shop and all that. Leisure, he cultivated his land. Around the house, he got some land. He got about 2-3 acres. He cultivated. He planted coconuts and other things. One of these lands now, in one of these lands, my brother built a house in later life. He stayed there.
Tell me a bit about the village life those days. What was life like? Everyday life?
It was very leisured life. People did not, as a profession, cultivate the land. They just plant something. They had to plant something. There was Kanduri and Kalyanam and all that. They had some religious connection in all those things. We used to participate in those things. Only social life people had at that time was some function in the mosque or functions in various houses. Apart from that, there were no societies and unions and so on and so forth, nothing like that. Very leisured life they had. People used to go to, most of the people in Telugavata and various places, even some in Kurukuta, they went to the Vanni area, the dry zone. It was called Vanni, mm-hmm. the dry zone, north of Matale. They ran their businesses and things like that and came here. Came back home, stayed a couple of months or so, then went back like that. It was like that. People who were permanently sent out here, not going anywhere, they didn't have much of a job for Yantam or Vijay Bhai. It was about cook, cottage, book, boutiques. and
sports. No, people did not play much sports.
They didn't have sports. Later, like a little later, when I was about 15 to 16 years, 15 to 20, there were volleyball teams. We were all very good volleyball players. Sometimes we used to get a challenge from the Singhades area, Halavathikala and so on, and Kudugala. Once all of us went to Kudugala, I remember. When they saw that our people, they were going to go to chat. They said, very reason why they can't play the match today. And we had a meeting and chatted with them and came back. It was a very, very strong team. Our team was a very strong one.
Right.
Then we used to play volleyball. Our only game was volleyball. Youngsters, we used to play.
Tell me about your university life.
University life. When we went to the university, there was no discrimination. No discrimination. We all studied. Then some of us took part in plays and so on. And we had lots of friends from other communities. All my friends were from other communities. Christians, Buddhists, and Singhades, and myself, and others. We used to get to, anywhere we go, even to get in, we used to go in a batch like that. Even when you go to the library from a house or resident, we used to go together. Not very eventful, except to study. University, now, recently, our people, my nephew, one of them is my nephew, my sister's son, my late sister's son, nephew was Maru. Maru, he did very well and he went as a lecturer in an American university. And he passed off there recently, about 1 year back or so.
Yeah, both Irfan and myself have met him. Yeah, we went to his house in Washington.
In
Washington, in America.
You went to Washington?
Yeah, as well as Irfan.
Yeah, you met him. You have talked a great deal.
Exactly. Yes.
Then, presently, I have my grandson.
So when did you finish university?
1957. I went and joined after the degree. Immediately after the degree, these people, my elders, got together and got me married to my father-in-law's daughter.
Yeah.
So I got married. My first job was as a teacher at Lahore College, Gampala.
Right, under Badiuddin.
Yes, Badiuddin still remembers me as a good teacher.
Right.
When people from Upper Lord to see him or something, he said, so and so is a good teacher.
Right.
So then from there I went to Gardina, government school. There, Lahore College, no prospect of promotion.
Mm-hmm.
Then you know, salary also a little less than a government school teacher.
Right.
So I went to Galina as a teacher, but since there was no Muslim was a graduate who was highly qualified, they made me the vice principal, acting principal.
Right.
From Galina I went back to university to do my postgraduate degree in education, diploma in education.
Yes.
I got that. Then after that also I came back to, I came back to Galina.
Right.
Galina.
This was which period?
1960s. Late 1950s.
So again, what was your graduation? What was your field in the university? Law or arts?
I did history.
History.
Yes.
History.
After I went as principal of a Muslim teachers training college. I had the degree or qualification also.
Yes. Yes.
With a very high salary at that time.
Yes.
Muslim training college that was situated in Kandy, Hirasagar. Later it was closed down because Muslims were said to have too many training colleges. One in Kandy and one in God, they were both closed down.
Mm-hmm.
I went as principal of the Muslim training college in Kandy.
Mm-hmm.
Then after that closed, I came to Akurana.
Mm-hmm.
From Akurana, I
So when did you come to Akurana?
That was in 1964 January, I think.
Right.
Yes.
Right.
I was an assistant teacher.
Right.
Then from there I went to, I was sent to Kathankudi.
Okay.
Kathankudi in Batikuru.
Yes.
They were also agitating for a principal for a long time. They didn't get a principal whom they liked. So when I went and tried to come to Kandy, they were all opposed to that. They went in deputy and divided places, and don't send so also, let me here. Anyway, after the 1965 election, I was sent back to London.
Right.
Yeah. From there, Akurana and so on. 1970 to 77, I was in Akurana. That was the time I made some big contribution to education here. It was a post-primary school, Akurana, from high classes. And there was an arts, high class, university entrance class, arts. But they didn't produce much result, 1 to 2 were sent to university. But that was all. I started the science advanced level classes, science and commerce and so on. And I did them, I did very well. And students were made to study. And I devised a scheme, my own scheme, to make the children and the study of the teachers to teach. Teachers didn't like it because that meant hard work for them.
Yes.
My scheme is to follow in hard work. One man said, "Sir, I can't work at it. You send me even to Timbuktu, any place is all right, I can't work at it." Because my scheme was such that if the teacher did not teach, they were caught.
Yep.
They must do their work, otherwise they were by the system of my supervision, they were caught. So some people, most people didn't like it, but some people expressed my dislike in a big way. So results are very good.
Yeah. One of the beneficiaries is my brother.
Who?
He went to engineering. He studied during a period.
Phalil. Yes.
My brother.
Your brother, I remember. How is he doing?
Yeah, he's doing well. I saw him yesterday also.
He was in the science class.
Yeah, he did maths.
Yes.
But he remembers you really well and always, he will talk about you whenever there is a conversation about Azhar.
Yeah, there are a lot of, brought in a lot of discipline.
Yes.
They were disciplined. Sports also, our people like you, our students.
Mm-hmm.
They were, defeated their chief rival in sports, Madhavala.
Okay.
Our students won like that.
Mm-hmm.
Then it was all work. At Azhar it was all work and no there was.
Mm-hmm.
Play the boot.
Right.
My system was such. The other Muslim schools, they don't follow that.
Mm-hmm.
So that the principal must be very keen about that. He must go about and see to it that scheme was followed. Otherwise, education suffers. I did that.
Mm-hmm.
Then a lot of people passed the university exam. Somebody university, like that.
Mm-hmm.
The system was very good and parents used to say, nowadays children, they don't play about, they study.
Mm-hmm.
You hear that?
Mm-hmm.
They study at home.
Mm-hmm.
One man later life, he told me, my children, my child, that fellow was in the central bank in Jaffna. My son in Jaffna, he is getting a good salary, he is doing well, all day with you. You must be happy.
Mm-hmm.
And all that. A lot of people come and tell him.
Right.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Yes. And school from a post-primary school, within 6-7 years, it became a big school with people from outside, Akron also come here, came there.
Yes.
With a lot of with lot of students, students went to various universities.
Mm-hmm.
And all that due to my scheme.
Yes, yes.
My scheme.
Yes.
Nobody could escape. Children can't escape. That's the other small, these young children,
mm-hmm.
they don't like to stay at home and study. No?
Yeah.
Yeah, these will study.
Mm-hmm.
Because everything will record it.
Yeah.
If that, now you have better facilities now with the computer and all that, you could do marvels.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But now they're doing that.
Mm-hmm.
It's a difficult task.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Because school, the main thing is study. No?
Yes.
You must improve that. I did that.
Mm-hmm.
I was in the bad books of politicians. I was prevented from going to school.
Right.
After the elections, I was prevented from going to school. If I went, I would have got resolved.
Uh-huh.
That was the situation at that time.
Uh-huh.
I lost my job by that.
Mm-hmm.
The politicians' activities
mm-hmm.
in 1977. In 1989, I got my job back, the department gave me
mm-hmm.
my job back, and after that I fought and got the salary, and for 12 years I was out of job now.
Yeah.
I got the back wages, the salary
yeah.
for the 12 years.
Okay.
They admitted their mistake.
Right. A.C.S. Samir,
yes.
even though he was in UMP,
yes.
but he's also your neighbor.
And my relation also.
Yeah. Briefly tell us about A.C.S. Samir.
He used to help them in their business activities in various parts of Ceylon. They get it, got it to some travel with somebody. Irrespective of what the reason was, they used to go to him and he used to help them. The people liked him. Business people liked him. So that way he was very popular. The Akuna school system was changed, spearheaded by me as principal of Azhar. I got Mr. Habib's cooperation also, because he could not, he had to cooperate with me in that matter. We reorganized the Akuna schools, all of them. That is, all the surrounding schools surrounding Azhar, they became primary schools up to grade 5, up to and including grade 5. From there, the students came to Azhar. Azhar became a really post-primary school, like a college. And everybody was keen to come to Azhar.
Hmm.
So we did some good work.
Yeah, as well as you are related to A.C.S. Samir,
yeah.
you are also related to Dr. Mauru.
Yeah, Dr. Mauru. We all went to school together in the school bus.
Right.
When I was going to Kandy.
Right.
His father was a very capable man. He used to get anything done. In government, he used to get anything done. People used to take him and do things. Mauru was a very studious man, and he was good in sports also in the school, I think that's what he was telling me. Then he contested and lost. My brother-in-law was Dr. Mauru's youngest uncle,
mm-hmm.
Mauru's father's youngest brother.
Mm-hmm.
So that way we are related, no?
Not only family, I'm asking about the community relationship, political relationship.
Political relationship that started with with some event in Azhar,
mm-hmm.
there was a school building passed.
Mm-hmm.
So there was nobody there to take up the contract
mm-hmm.
to build it. Ultimately they said, principal, you please do it, we'll all help and all that. And some people gently forced me to undertake that.
Okay.
And I also needed a building.
Mm-hmm.
Halfway through we went through some experiences due to the physical feature of the place and various things. I went to Mr. Habib. He said, He didn't do anything. Then we went to myself and another friend of mine, traditional, we went to Dr. Maru. Maru was having ideas at that time. So Maru said, yes, I will help you. And that's how this thing started. It started with the welfare of Azad. But this Akuna water scheme, it came when the SNP was in power. Ratwatthaye was the minister in the government. So somehow the Maru said he the one who put the water scheme for Akuna. That may be correct. People don't know that. People don't know that.
Sir, I just heard that he had contributed something to Israel and Palestine conflict.
Yeah, he was very strongly keen on Palestinian cause.
Palestinian cause. His father was keen. From that he inherited this craze for the Palestinian cause. He used to organize various contributions in Akurla, made the people aware that there was a Palestinian cause like this, and he used to collect various things and send them to Palestine. Palestinian, that was also a platform for his election, election effort.
Right.
He contested, no?
Yes. This
Palestinian, that was also a platform.
Right, yes. Right. So he did the Palestinian course before entering politics?
Yes. Yes. Much before entering politics. Probably had political ideas, but nobody knew that he was aiming at a political advantage. But you can't say that he did this for sake of politics. He was genuinely interested in the Palestinian cause.
Yeah.
Genuinely interested, and that was probably he got it from his father.
Dr. Maruf and the Israel-Palestine mission in the paper.
LFP Vandarune Srima booked them out.
Oh, yeah.
That's all. அதுக்கு ஜேஆர் எது தரப்பில் இப்ரேஷன் தெரியும் இது வந்தது ஜேஆர் பவருக்கு வந்து பிறகு லீடிங் முஸ்லீம்ஸ் இன் கலம்பு முஸ்லீம் லீக் பீப்புள் டாக்டர் காலேஜில் வெரி வெரி பீப்புள் டேவிட் ஜெயவர்தன் வாண்டட் ஹிம் டு சேஞ்ச் ஆஃப் த இஸ்ரேலிஸ் தென் தி பீப்புள் ஹட் ஷார்ட் ஆஃப் ஆர்கியூ டு சேஸ்னோ He had said, if you, my doors are wide open for you to go out. He had said, and they came back.
You know, the way we had our culture was very much linked to religion. So were there different practices than the current practice we see?
We used to go during drought period. We used to go from one end of the road to the other. We used to go. You know, somewhere on the Thirumugavatha road, people used to go reciting Maru from there to some big kande in Thirumugavatha.
So how about your family? How many children you have?
I have 6 children.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
4 girls and 2 boys.
Yeah.
My girls, they went to a lady school. My three daughters went to a leading school in Kandy.
Okay.
My grandchildren, this Zakwan, I told you, he got a first class in double match.
Okay, is there anything else that you like to share with other people?
Period in Azhar.
Yeah.
As principal.
Yeah.
People still honor me.
Yes.
They say that you only brought up that school.
Yeah.
Like this. They made me chief guest in various events and all that.
Yes.
Some people did not like me at that time. The leading people in Akurana, in the post 1960s, they did not like the people becoming educated. Because educated people, they start asking questions. I was one of those who asked a lot of questions. They are asking questions now. So they didn't want to develop education. So no school. Otherwise, Azhar should have much more facilities now than those days. Yes, some people, all the people didn't like educating the people because educated people start asking questions.
Okay. Mr. Kapoor, thank you so much. Very nice to speak to you.
Thank you very much.
And I'm very thankful for your time also.
Having shared these experiences.
That's okay. Yeah. Wish you all the best.
Yeah, thank you.